Hello everyone, this is DK Magician and I welcome you to another episode of my Mar Deck playthrough. We did actually really nice stuff in the last episode, which was basically doing half of the Water Temple. And you know what we're actually going to do? We're getting the hell out. Yeah, this is how we start our episode. We actually got all the items to recreate the, the robot thing. So, it's called Legion. It's actually you're going to start this episode. We have all the ingredients now, so let's get to casting the spell. But how do we go from here? Well, let's have a look at what we have to do with these ingredients. With the ingredients in our possession, the spell seems to be surprisingly easy to do, considering its forbidden dark magic and everything. It seems that you might even be able to cast it yourself. In fact, it says that whoever casts the spell will become the master of the Bound Soul, and I think it should be you rather than me. So, what do I need to do then? You need to concentrate on the object that you want the soul to be bound to, concentrate all your willpower and say these magic words here. There's also a bit of energy manipulation, but it doesn't seem necessary for the person who says the word to do the energy pushing. So I'll do that bit while you just say the words, right? Yes, but I can't certain to read those words that I'm supposed to say. Oh, right, you can't. If I speak them to you now, it might bugger something up or half cast a spell or who knows what. So, do you have some kind of writing implement, like a pencil or something? Alright, I have my lucky page right here. Okay, I've written down a phonetic translation that you should be able to read, so just read those out and you should be fine. Okay, thank you! Now, where do we begin? First I'll need to shape the energies appropriately, like it says in that book. It will take a few seconds, but you won't know when I'm done, so just wait a while and you should be fine. Once the energies are set up properly, I can hold them like that for a while, so you can't wait too long. Then you just have to say the magic words in a loud, confident voice while focusing hard on the object you want to bind to. The metal man there, here. Nice handiwork, by the way, that's amazing! Thank you! It means a lot coming from you, Miss Shaman. You know, you're speaking the magic words. You'll know you're speaking the magic words properly because your voice will go all magically and dramatic. The words will sort of try to force themselves out, form themselves, so it won't be too hard even if you don't have any magical skills. Yes, okay. Let's get started now, shall we? Are you ready, sir? I'm ready. Then please give me a few moments while I ready the energies. And she's like in hands now. And wait, I hope it's long enough, because... Oh, contra el bella monte, she is the death! Now we have all this semantic. Did it work? No, you didn't say the spell right, because, you know, there were full, like, souls that went into it. Metal Man, can you hear me? Processing. What the devil? Where in the dear Lord of Glory's name am I? What am I, a blasted kettle? I can see, feel, hear, but... What is the meaning of this? Hello there? What? What is this? Isn't it the afterlife? Who are you people? What is this thing that I mean? Who are you? Me? This is my space that we're referring there, whoever or wherever you are. Oh, bloody wonderful disease. Just when I thought I'd got out of this insufferably depressing world, I get wrenched right back in the again for my son madman. Ugh. Truly, my misery is endless. Utterly, utterly endless. The gods despise me, I see. What a world. Life! Is this supposed to happen? I don't know. Maybe it's because the thing you're trying to put the soul into, or... it seems too many souls were summoned. It's all my fault, my stammer. It affected the magic words. Yes, yes, very interesting and all that, but what the hell is this and who are you, you tiny feeble little mouse? Please don't antagonize the man, this will be all just some kind of mistake of or misunderstanding. I'm sure that things will go back to their natural order in a few minutes. So let's savor this experience while we can. I bet it's just some evil wizard again, making me suffer for his own amusement. Just like the gods throughout my whole existence. Why can't it just end? Oh, I'm made of metal, shiny, my legs feel funny, haha, where am I? Not the pixies again, the pixies, I don't like escaping them and I'll drill them out of my hair. But why do they continue to torment me? I'll get them, come out pixies. Hello there again, I'm Meriador, an inventor and built this metal body, a truly wonderful piece of machinery. It can be used to like a living human body, but without any of the bodily needs. I have summoned your soul or souls to ask you help in an experiment. You see, we don't know what happens after that. We aren't sure, but by summoning souls into a form that allows them to speak to us and act like a living thing once more, we can learn, maybe. I also wish to create the ultimate man. Your machine body is equipped with a mechanical brain that does not lose memories. Every skill you learn stays fresh in your mind, and what you can learn is nearly unlimited. Currently, you are capable of little physically, but there is so much you can learn to help us all, to assist the world in many ways. The ultimate man? But I'm a woman. A woman? I'm living in some tin can with a ruddy woman. Now I'll surely have to listen to incessant winging inside my own head. Depressing, isn't it? Anyway, why in the glorious hills which I was just busy trying to conquer before you? Glorious hells. Not hills. Hells! Before you attrapped me in your cage, you simpering curl, should I help you? What is this? This for me? You'll have to experience life anew with a nine invisible body? This means I can't even kill myself to get rid of the bloody miserable drudgery of it all. How depressing. This all seems so against nature. Invincible body, you say? I cannot die! Take that! Pixie scum! Scum! You can't get me now because I'll get you! I'll get you, pixies! I have a second chance! So let me be sure of this, little toy maker. You have summoned I, the great Baron von Domkill, from the throes of death into a night invincible ultimate death machine, and you accept me to just obey you? It's quite formal. I think I'll go on a rampage instead and conquer the world again, the world with no fear. No fear, no fear, ha ha ha. Now look what you've done. You've gone and done, inventor person. You should know that things always turn out exactly the way you don't want them to. It makes me so miserable to just thinking about it. You should have never trusted anything, you know. You'll always end up regretting it. I always have. Actually, the nature of the spell that we cast is that binds your soul, or in this case, souls, to an object, yes. But it also binds them in a service to a master. You simply have no choice but to obey Mr. Meriador here. What? I'm a slave? How the pre... You're one of the pixies, aren't you? Slavery is not the way of nature. This is so unnatural, and I really must insist that you listen to your conscience and set us free into the astral realm once more. Actually, this does feel wrong. Maybe we can do the spell again? Unfortunately, that is not possible. I should have warned you about it before you cast it, but the spell is not one that can be reversed. The only way to release the soul is to destroy the object it's bound to, so unless you want to destroy the Metal Man... I spent years of my life making that thing. Wait, that looks like so very extreme. Maybe you could just disassemble the man and try to put it together again, not exactly destroy it, you know? This... might work enough. If I can control Metal Man, then it won't go on any evil rampages than having multiple souls to speak with to learn. Will it be better all around? Bruh, I hate it when people look on the bright side. I see. This is unnatural, I realize, but you people do seem to have noble goals for a middle. You don't seem to be an evil wizard at any rate. I would be glad to help you until my time here is done. It will be a learning experience for us all, and we have an eternity to exist as souls anyway, so this isn't robbing us of precious time. You cannot control me! I refuse to be your slave, you damned blasted! Interesting, it seems that we four souls are each capable of controlling this machinery of yours, but only once at a time. We can stifle this Baron Fondum kill if you like. Not all the time you can't, you swine fondly goat bothering cretins! I'll feed you to the demons! God boogering! Funny! Oh, so sorry, I've not even introduced myself. I am Dinah, the shaman of a place called Canonia. Do you know it? Or at least I was a shaman. It could have been hundreds of years ago, though. I have no idea how long it was since I lived. Oh, a shaman! Really? Me too! I'm shaman of Canonia now! There's so much you can teach me then! This is delightful coincidental then. People knew me as miserable old Martin, though I can't imagine why. I mean, my name is Eric, not Martin. I am Meriador, the inventor. Pleased to meet you all. And I'm the thing of your nightmares are made from. I ruled this world with an iron fist of darkness once, and I shall do so again. In time, you will see, you will regret these slugs. Me too, I am not a pixie, hey! It seems that we'll have a lot to get used to this arrangement here. It seems that the body we inhabit isn't able to move much just by our own accord. Perhaps we'll have to give us an order or something, master? Okay. I order you metal men to follow me, but not kill anyone. You can move on to your own accord now, but don't attack anyone. I bet it doesn't work and you all die painful deaths while we get trapped in here until the universe ends. Your first and last mistake, little man. It seems that I am able to move now, so I shall attack and you shall... Damn it to the hell, this isn't working! Yes, it seems that we can move now. The body simply halts before it's able to strike anything. Interesting. But the pixies can get us now! Also, are you going to keep us calling us Metal Man? I don't much care for being referred to a male. Technically, none of us are a male or female at the moment due to being an artificial sexless automaton possessed by disembodied spirits, which is depressing because now do I ever have to look forward to doing the evenings. What would be a better way of referring to you collectively? Just the invincibly and utterly grand Baron von Doomkill will suffice. You will not need to acknowledge the existence of these other nitwits at all. Legion? Legion? Ah, I see the logic in that. It's a demon man, right? Yes, the demon man. There's this tale you see of a man who was possessed by a whole group of demons, so it was like he had multiple voices, multiple personalities, and asked him why is that name? And he answered saying, my name is Legion, for we are many. So I don't the name fit, do you? Well, it's certainly catchy and appropriate. I don't much care for essentially being called a demon though, but it will suffice. I am worse than being demons, but being a knowledge as such will do for now. Well, Mardek, you are still here! You see, DK has talked now so much, he needs to continue adventure, otherwise people will just think that this episode is just me talking. Also, I think that now we have Legion here, I think my travels with you are over. Really, but... Wait, what are you actually going to do now that you have a Metal Man up and running? What is it for? Well, I made it so that it can learn things, which it can. Watching people perform tasks, it can memorize them and use them itself. I wanted to learn a multitude of skills, so then it will be useful in any situation to people everywhere. Once this has collected enough data, I would use it to make copies of the same memories built in. How do you intend to teach it? Well, I was just planning on showing it books, maybe schools of my own. But wouldn't that be rather slow and its knowledge limited? What about, say, instead we come with me, us, Mardek and all of us, and Legion comes through and watches our enemies learn their skills? But then it will only learn combat skills, which are the only things that matter in an RPG, a mediador. Not necessarily. It could learn other skills by watching people in our travels, like skilled artisans or craftsmen. Well, that does sound like a good idea. And to be honest, I doubt that I could stand to do this by myself anyway. If I were to left alone with you, with feeble little shrew, I would find a way to end you. That I swear. Then it's decided. You and Legion will accompany us in your journeys, right, Bardek? It's okay, I think. Well, thank you. This will be interesting. It has probably been a long time since I've seen the world, and I'm very interested to see how much it has changed since I've been born. I bet it's worse than ever, since it's surely descended into a hive of miserable scum and villainy. There is nothing where nothing works right, and the evil people rule and all that. It makes me depressed just thinking about it. Surely it cannot be as wretched as it was when I ruled it, but it is I, even if it's not, shall soon be in charge of once more to reduce the grim chaos, a living hell, oh yeah. There will be pixies, Anyway, let's go. We've talked for far too long, eh? And we now have Legion, which we can add to our party, which we shall do. So, we are actually going to take Mereador for a little while. And yeah, it stays like this for now. And let's go and save. We save here. And yeah, Legion has some really nice dialogues, because let's say, for example, I remember this place once with an iron fist at the paws of darkness, and I shall do it so again in due time. Just so you wait and see, little pipsqueaks, I will murder you all! Yeah, but the more interesting about Legion is not only its story, but also its mechanics. They're just so interesting. So basically what he does is that he learns skills as he sees enemies using them. And he has a crap load of skills to learn from, which is really nice. But yeah, right now, well, actually I think let's leave Charlotte for now. Because yes, or maybe she could have been useful in the Water Temple, more useful than Mereador potentially. I don't really know, decisions, but Mereador and Legion work so fine together, you know. Yeah, let's get rid of Charla. I want to take her items. No, I'm clicking the wrong place. Item storage. So, sorry Charla, you did a tremendous job. You were actually more useful than I think of, because, you know, in my playthroughs I don't often play with her that much. I just use, like, a physical attacker, like Slank or something. But, yeah, speaking about Slank, let's give him his axe. His axe right here. But yeah, this time I got to play with her around a little bit more than usual, which was nice. And she was actually pretty strong. So yeah, I'm gonna miss her a little bit, but Legion will, like, surely sooner or later just take her place, because Legion is just, let's say, more versatile, you know. He just learns a lot of important stuff, useful stuff. So I think we just migrate all of these to Legion. Okay, now you are going to learn this thing from your clothes first, and after that we'll need to craft you better armor and equipment, and you can do that by coming here to Mereador's workbench, and it's these things here. So an emerald, fire essence, earth essence, and a physical runestone. Yeah, we don't have any of these. They're not that hard to obtain though, so we might come back later. As for this defensive stuff, copper plating. I have this already. Probably, I need to check out my inventory. Iron armor, I have this, I'm pretty sure. Silver ring and golden punch. Golden punch, there's like a somewhat limited supply at the moment of this thing, but I should be able to craft it later, I guess. But yeah, I won't use these yet, because we still have skills to learn from these, so... copper plating is the one that I'm using at the moment, never mind. So iron armor, silver ring and golden conch. Iron armor, silver ring, golden conch. golden conch. I need to check how many golden conches do I have. Let me check. If I could craft that right away, it will be done. But yeah, I think that there's some fish somewhere that drops it. Okay, copper breastplate. Or a breastplate, I don't really know. How many golden conches do I have? Just have two. Ah, crap. Whatever, no problem. So let us equip Legion with all the skills that we want him to have. That will be these ones for now. This is actually so great, like immune to poison, zombification and bleeding. But I need to equip this skill and I want him to learn the others, so he's going to learn the others first. Arc resistance is nice. Okay, and he started learning this. So to showcase it all, let us go first to Canonia. I also want to speak to Legion here. Yes, it's such a strange feeling to be back at this place. It hasn't changed much all the time I was a shaman here. However long ago that was, it was a sleepy forest village then, and it's a sleepy forest village now. I'm glad it's still here at all. Yeah, it's a boring place. So we're going to do nice stuffs, not boring stuffs. Let's go to the Canonian Woods. There are a few enemies here that teach me nice skills, like this one. Just use that on Legion, please. Crap. So it won't happen exactly always as you want it to happen, but yeah. Also, we got Repair on Legion, which what it does is that increases all its stats, which is really great, and fully restores me it, which is great as well. So let us learn some skills. Come on. We got Poison Sting, which is actually a really important skill. It's such a simple skill. Like, think about Pokemon for example. Like, every bug Pokemon knows that skill in the early beginning, but it is really important for this game to poison things. So you can just click here and you poison things. Except that thing resists Earth, so it didn't need anything, but yeah. There you go. Also kind of weird that Meriador is at not over there. I would like things to be switched, you know. Let's see if we can do that. Okay, now that we have Poison Thingy, we may try and go to that dungeon. There are a few more skills that we can learn there, so we might as well just do that. Go here. Tainted Grotto, and let's just walk a little bit inside and hopefully learn skills fast. Okay, I think that this is one of the enemies that teaches skills, if I recall correctly. Oh crap, that this was overkill. Let's see what it does. Oh, never mind. I thought that that guy was like quite impervious to physical damage, but yeah. Then again, that was chapter 2, now it's chapter 3. And yeah, I remember that I needed a Mela to get rid of those enemies. Not anymore now. So, yeah, let us just wait. Okay, this is these guys again. Let us try and avoid attacking them, actually. Maybe it's not this enemy and I'm messing up. No, it's not stone. I'm messing up with the balloon, I think. It's the one that uses this skill. Or maybe not, I'll just have to check that. So we got an antidote. Let's just wander around a little bit until we find actually that enemy. Also, I think I want Mardek to learn more power, you know, more magical damage. So we can go here to Mardek and teach him this, so his heals will be stronger. Okay, let's wander around and see if we can find the balloon. Okay, here they are. So let's just wait. I think they teach me acid and balloon. I think they teach me two skills at the same time, if I recall correctly. But yeah, we need to check. Poison, not nice. Okay, acid is one of them. So let us remove taint from this guy. And okay, he has now acid and poison sink. So this thing inflicts earth damage and sometimes inflicts poison or numbness. I think it's pretty rare that when that happens, but yeah. And repair. Acid. Yeah, I think these guys numb. Oh, that's annoying. Okay, let's just get rid of them. There we go. Okay, maybe I actually already learned the things I had to learn here. But yeah, now Legion has already two earth skills. This guy learns magic water via minus 50%, so we can swap this thing out. Okay, let us actually leave this place. And okay, do you remember when you had to fight those very annoying enemies from the Dream Realm? And they are very strong and such. Yeah, Legion can learn some of those skills too. In fact, I should go to Gloria's place now, the Dream Cave. And it should have some stuff unlocked here, I think, because there are switches here that I unlocked. Oh, there's a green switch. Crap. So there you go. You actually haven't unlocked all switches yet. I need to do some exploring to see where is that green switch, but I don't really remember where it is. It's probably somewhere in the Dream Realm, maybe in Lifewood or something, but yeah. Actually, I think that these guys are one of the few that teach you anything at all. What are you weak against? Everything. Or nothing at all. There you go. Let's move. I want to fight some whims and forgotten faces now. And even pixies actually, because those teach me nice stuff. And come on. When you want to fight, you never find fights. Okay, here they are. Not these. Not these either. Well, actually, there's nothing we can do. So. Let us just do this. No. No. Regeneration. Because. No! This is not what I wanted to do. No! You are not helping. Let us just wait. Get this guy repaired. I think I can learn two skills in this fight. One of them is this, which is nice. It can inflict paralysis, which I like. And the other one is this, but it pick a target. So wait. Yes. Good one. Yeah, when Meriador is confused, he does absolutely nothing. Also, this is not nice. What a miss. Spectral touch, please. Well, with that being said, I can just defeat these guys and search for another fight. Yeah, I'll do that. I think it's more sensible now to do that. Let's see how much this does. It does okay. Crap, can't do anything because I'm silenced. So let's try and defeat these guys. Let's see if Poison Sink does more. Actually not. How much defense does that guy have anyway? Oh, she cured herself of her... Yeah, 20% resistance, yeah. She cured herself of silences, which is really nice. So let's use this. Oh, and Dark Claw. Completely forgot about this. Dark Claw is really, really, really nice. Really great skill. Let's use it against this guy. See? Now it's not only my deck that can use like elemental type damage, or not elemental, like moral type damage, but Legion can do that too. Also, Meredor learns evasion. Let me try to find another fight with Forgotten Faces, maybe three of them if I'm lucky. And just try to learn that Spectral Touch as well. Yeah, but yeah, that Dark Claw was a really nice surprise. I wasn't really expecting that attack. And yeah. Also this one. We can learn this nice skill. Really nice. And this we already know. So yeah. Okay, as you know, this enemy is annoying. Let's see if we can get rid of it. Crap. There is still that accuracy problem with this guy. It's not easy to defeat because of that. Come on. Oh no, Mardek. You were almost there. No, Legion. I think you can learn this. So, Poison Sting already know. Arteel, I guess. Let us just keep the Legion off the curse. And I think I can use Dark. I can use Dark. Miss. Ah. Yes, there you go. So we now have even one more skill for Legion. And yeah, you can see we're not putting that much effort into it. It's been like nice and easy. Let me see how many we have now. Dark Claw, Curse, Edelgas, Poison Sting and Acid. Which is really nice. So let us get out of here. And yeah, this episode was all about Legion. And yeah, he's just such a great character that I really like him, and yeah. I am pretty sure that he will replace Sharla, like, better. Also, okay, that is the formation I want. I want you to be switched, like that. So it returns to their original positions. So, here's what we're going to do. We need to continue the thing that we are doing in the water temple, you know. Because there's like a water and temple in it, and with that thing we have our main quest to do. So let's get ourselves there. Or actually not. Let us just save here. So save. There we go. And yeah, that is what we're going to do in the next episode. We're going inside that lake again and finish up that lake thing, water temple thing. But yeah, that was all for this one. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to click that like button if you like this type of content. And yeah, I'll see you around for the next one. Bye bye!